Hello everyone. In today's video, we will study post-fertilization event, which is the last step of the sexual reproduction. We have already finished the fertilization event in the previous video, wherein we have discussed that double fertilization is a characteristic feature of the angiospermic plant. Now, once fertilization is done, means double fertilization, means when zygote is formed and primary endosperm nucleus is formed, then this gives a signal to the plant and various changes occurs. So these all the terms which are written in blue, we will see one by one what happens to them after fertilization or post fertilization. So sepals, they have done their job now. They will not be functional now, so they will fall off. Now similarly, petals will be of no use now, they will also fall off. Anthers will be of no use now, they will also fall off. Ovary, very important that ovary after fertilization, it forms the fruit. So ripened ovary or the fertilized ovary is known as fruit. And ovule inside the ovary, prior to fertilization, they are known as ovule. But once fertilization is done, they are known as seed. So ovule will transform into the seed. Outer integument means the outer coat of the ovule. It will transform into the seed coat, and the outer integument will form the outer seed coat. This outer seed coat is named as testa. The inner integument will form the inner seed coat. So inner seed coat has a specific name, and that name is tegmen. Funicle, which was seen in the ovule, it will stay as funicle only. New cell is very important. If it will be there in the seed, then it will be known as perisperm. Hilum will stay as such. Zygote will divide to form an embryo, and primary endosperm nucleus, that was actually triploid in nature because it was formed by the fusion of three haploid cells, so it will grow into endosperm. Now once embryo has to form, prior to the embryo formation, always endosperm, they have to divide first, and there is a specific reason for it. So always, whenever embryo has to form, endosperm, they have to divide first, because endosperm will be giving nutrition to the developing embryo. So it is a must that endosperm should divide first. So endosperm can divide by three processes. Means these divisions will happen in the primary endosperm nucleus. If the divisions are happening regularly, means if the nucleus is dividing regularly, but there will be no division in the cytoplasm. So here you can see that multinucleated condition is there. But multinucleated condition is there, but cytoplasm has not divided. That means karyokinesis or division of the nucleus is happening, but division of the cytoplasm has not been happened. So initially such structure is seen where many nuclei are seen. Now later what happens? The division cytokinesis or the division of the cytoplasm, it happens from the periphery towards the center. So you can see that wall formation is happening at the periphery or the boundary, but not in the center. You might have seen coconut. Coconut prominently divides by free nuclear endospermic divisions, in which first free nuclear divisions occurs and no cytokinesis occurs. But later wall formation occurs on the periphery, and the liquid which you drink from the coconut is actually the free nuclei, because no cytokinesis has happened in them. So such type of division is known as free nuclear endosperm, which is seen in coconut. Next type of endospermic division is cellular endosperm, where every division of the nucleus means every karyokinesis or division of the nucleus follows cytokinesis. Means each nuclei will be there in a specific cell only. And such type of endospermic division is known as cellular endosperm, which is seen in Dhatura. Now the last type of endospermic division is helobial type of division, which is quite uncommon and rare. In this, it is a mixture of free nuclear and cellular endosperm. Means cells will be formed, some will follow the cytokinesis and some will not. So this is not important. Only it is important to know the term that helobial endosperm is a mixture of free nuclear and cellular endosperm. Now once endosperm is formed, it is ready to help zygote in forming the embryo. So zygote, you know, it was formed by the fusion of one male gamete with an egg. And once zygote is formed, it is unicellular, it is diploid. And by the process of embryogeny, it will form embryo. So we will discuss how embryos, they are formed in the dicots. Means the seeds that have two cotyledons, how embryo develops in them. So this is zygote. M defines the micropylar end and C defines the chalazal end. Now you can see here zygote has divided asymmetrically, means unequally, and the apical cell is smaller and the basal cell is somewhat bigger. This apical cell will always be formed near the chalazal end, and basal cell, of course, it will be near to the micropylar end. Basal cell will also be known as suspensor cell, and apical cell will be known as embryonal cell. Because apical cell will form the embryo and basal cell will form the suspensor. Now after this, what happens is, so this is your second picture after the first one. You can see that basal cell, it is dividing latitudinally, or you can also use the term transversely. And by transverse division, you can see that numerous cells are formed and each cell has its nucleus. So by transverse division, it has formed a structure which is known as suspensor. Whereas the apical cell will divide by two vertical divisions and one transverse division. So two vertical divisions and one transverse division will happen. And then this structure where you can see six cells, the division will happen along its transverse wall too. So by this way, you will get two tires. Two tires means in the front part also six cells will be there, and in the back part also six cells will be there. Now these divisions, they are happening simultaneously. In the suspensor, this outer cell, means the cell which is closest to the micropyle, it will form haustoria. Haustoria will be a structure that will be developed at the micropylar end and it will give the nutrition to the growing embryo. Beside haustoria, endosperm also gives the nutrition for embryogeny process. Now, haustoria is the outermost cell and the cell which is farthest from the haustoria in the suspensor, it will form hypophysis. Means the first cell towards the micropylar end will form the haustoria, which will help in deriving the nutrition from the micropylar end, and the last cell will help in forming the hypophysis. Now hypophysis will form the root. Hope you remember the structure of root, that root at their tip, they contain the root cap. So this is the root apex, and root apex is protected by the root cap. So this root cap is formed by hypophysis in the embryogeny. Now you have seen that two tires were formed. One tire will form the root apex. Because root cap has already been formed. Of course, now root apex has to be there. So root apex will be formed by one tier of the embryonal cell. And second tier which is formed, it will form plumule, it will form epicotyle, and it will also form cotyledons. So basically this is the theme which you must know, and then we will come on to the diagrams of the NCRT. Let's revise once again. Zygote was formed. It divided unequally. Smaller cell was apical cell towards the chalaza and larger one was the basal cell. Now basal cell, it is necessary that it will always divide transversely, and this will result in the formation of suspensor. Whereas the apical cell will divide by two vertical divisions and one horizontal division. Later, transverse division will happen in between to form two tiers, right? Now, the outermost cell will form the haustoria of the suspensor and the innermost cell will form the hypophysis. Haustoria will derive the nutrition from the micropylar end, and it will help in embryogeny. Endosperm also helps in embryogeny. Hypophysis will form the root cap. Two tiers were formed. One tier will form the root apex. Another tier will form plumule, epicotyle, and cotyledons. Now we will look into the diagrams which are given in the book. Please see carefully that here the zygote has divided unequally. This is your apical cell and this is your basal cell. I already told you that the apical cell can also be known as embryonal cell because it will form the embryo, and the basal cell can also be known as the suspensor cell because it has to form the suspensor. Now, the suspensor cells will always divide transversely to form a neck-like structure which is known as suspensor, which is seen here. And you can see that the cell which is here at the tip, this will form the haustoria, right? And here, the embryonal cell has divided many a times, and you can see that here, embryo has taken a globular shape. So here, the embryo is globular in shape. This is the neck, of course, suspensor cell. And this basal cell can be known as haustoria, which will again help in deriving the nutrition. These are all the cells which are formed in the embryo. Once it will differentiate it into two tiers, one tier will form plumule, epicotyle, and cotyledons. And these are the cotyledons. You can see that two edges are formed. That defines how many cotyledons will be formed. Of course, two. And here, please notice that embryo has taken heart shape. So embryo is drastically changing the shapes from globular to heart shape. And here the structures are well developed. Cotyledons are formed. This is the place between the two cotyledons is known as stem apex. Hypocotyle is one structure which is formed by the tier number 1. So tier number 1, which is destined to form the root apex, that will only form the epicotyle. This is your root tip and the root cap. So this is how embryo is located in the growing ovule. And once this is all done, ovule will be transformed into the seed. And the integuments of the ovule will form the seed coats. In next video, we will see the structure of the dicot seed. And we will compare that structure with the monocot seed. Thank you.